Om Sri Sai Ram. Prashanti Sandesh. Welcome to Sai Pearls of Wisdom. As we go through the history of avatars and great masters, we find them unbelievable, incomprehensible. Their love for the humanity is immeasurable, unfathomable. If we just study about Shirdi Bhagavan, we know that how he took to himself many diseases and accidents. The one known to everybody is this, how Shirdi Baba has stretched his hand into the fire, into the flames, and rescued the life of a child. Close by, there was a blacksmith working there with fire. Unfortunately, as ill luck would have it, his child was crawling and about to go into the fire, get into the fire, almost into the fire. Baba stretched his hand and saved the life of the child. And with the result, what happened? Baba's arm had burns. The burns, scars, that lasted for a long time. In other words, he has suffered. And you also know that in the Gospel of Sai Baba, also called Charters and Sayings, you will know that Baba is prepared to give up his life, if necessary, to save a devotee. And it is all believed that he died in the year 1918 only to save his devotee from death. Well, similar thing also we'll come across in the book Autobiography of a Yogi relating to Swami Yogananda. And also in the book Life of Sai Baba, written by Narasimha Swami, contain many of these incidents. Well, there's one doctor from Madurai. He was suffering from pain and bleeding in an ear. Suffering. And he wrote a letter to Kasturi. Sir, this is my situation. Kasturi received the letter and immediately got the phone call from Dr. Madurai. Kasturi ji, I am free from all pain and the bleeding in my ear. Then Kasturi asked, I received your letter only now. When did you have the cure? He said, just now, as you received my letter, I got myself cured. And then Kasturi told him, you know what happened? In your place, Baba has been suffering from bleeding and the earache. And he's totally free from that problem. He has taken upon himself your problem. That's what Kasturi said. That is the love of an avatar for his devotees. The biography also reveals many of the incidents how Baba has taken upon himself. Mumps, typhoid fever, even delivery pains and scalding burns of his devotees. His love is immense, yes. We cannot measure it. We can only listen to those miracles listen to those experiences and feel thrilled about it and grow more and more in devotion. 28th June 1963 is a very important event happened there. But that is fresh in the memory of many of the devotees of those times. What was it? On that day, Swami wanted Kasturi to make an announcement that there will be no interviews for a week to come. All right. The crowd dispersed. The very next day, the 29th of June, 1963, at 6:30 in the morning, Baba fell unconscious. Some of the devotees thought that he has gone beyond the body, transcended his body to rescue a devotee. But he was remaining unconscious for a long time. Therefore, the devotees decided to give some medical treatment. Besides the doctor from the ashram, they also had the services of Dr. Prasanna Simha Rao. Prasanna Simha Rao, he happens to be the assistant director, medical services of Mysore state then. They examined and said that Baba was suffering from tuberculosis, meningitis, and they call it tuberculoma. And the doctors decided to treat him. But Baba refused injections. He refused treatment and told them the trouble would pass in 5 days' time. They would be all right later. But what happened during these 4 days? Baba suffered several heart attacks. A clot in the brain, the left side of the body is paralyzed. With the result, body was stiff, useless, insensitive. Besides that, speech was affected badly. Then, July 4th, the same year, 1963, Swami sufficiently became clear and strong. The clots cleared. Heart attacks no more, because this would pass in 5 days. But however, left side still paralytic. The speech is still thick and feeble. And many of the people around thought that it would take a couple of months for Baba to recoup. So, Swami indicated that a devotee was to suffer from a stroke of this kind, repeated heart attacks, and the devotee is sure to die. Therefore, I have taken upon myself these problems. In the Guru Purnima day, July 6th, 1963. Baba's condition is like this. The body is stiff, useless. Speech is very much affected. What to do? His devotees brought him down from upstairs and brought him to the prayer hall. His speech is still feeble. Intelligent mumble. paralytic leg dragging, watching this situation, even the bravest would cry loudly. Baba sat in his chair on the dais. 5,000 devotees were present there. And Swami gestured to bring some water. And he sprinkled drops on the paralyzed part, the left hand and the left leg. And stroked his left hand with the right hand. And he stroked with both the hands, left hand, right hand, the left leg. With the result, what happened? He became normal. In a second, leg is normal, eyes normal, left side normal. Baba gave a speech. When Swami started his speech, as Kasturi describes, devotees jumped in joy. They danced. They shouted. Some cried. Some laughed hysterically. That day, the entire program took place as per the schedule. Bhajans went on. See that. How Swami suffered for 5 days to save the life of a devotee. We cannot imagine that. Really, as we read the entire narration written by Kasturi, we can't help crying, imagining those days. I should also bring to your attention another great, incredible miracle. There was a great scientist who was close to Swami, of international repute, by name Dr. Bhagavantam. And his grandson, 11-year-old boy, was mentally retarded. Retarded. Many doctors said some problem with his brain that has got to be operated. But the family members refused, thinking that the boy cannot take this strain, cannot withstand the surgery, because it is a trouble in the lumbar region, quite close to the backbone. And there's some fluid accumulated there. And that fluid must be taken out. That was the position of the boy. When Swami visited Dr. Bhagavantam, he has put some sympathetic questions, getting answers, both from the boy and his father. The father tried to explain the problem of his son. Before he just started, Baba started explaining the whole problem. And finally said, Baba said, this is the problem of your son. I will cure him. I'll do the needed surgery. Don't worry, Baba said. Baba materialized Vibhuti. He rubbed Vibhuti in the lumbar region. And then, surprisingly to everybody, Swami materialized a surgical needle of 4 inches long. The boy was semi-conscious at the time. Maybe that Vibhuti acted as anesthetic. It was a kind of anesthesia to that boy. And then Swami materialized that long needle, and he knows the correct spot in the lumbar region. And Baba pierced that needle into the lumbar region. Baba massaging back. He just with that needle extracted the fluid there in the lumbar region. And he has taken out the needle finally. He asked the father standing there watching this situation, full of wonder and awe, surprisingly, shockingly enough. Baba asked him, "Do you have surgical dressing at home?" Surgical dressing such as the cloth and other things, the cotton and other things. And the father's brother by name Ramakrishna, who is also a scientist, he said, "Swami, we'll get it in 10 minutes. The name of the father of the boy is Balakrishna. Balakrishna's brother Ramakrishna. He said, "Swami, we'll get the cotton and surgical requirements and all this, surgical dressing purpose, in 10 minutes. Baba smiled and said, "It is too long, it is too long. We cannot wait that long." And Baba waved his hand again and brought back that dressing material and brought back the boy to consciousness. All this had happened in such a way that there was no pain or discomfort to the boy. And Swami assured them, he will go on improving slowly, no problem. Did you come across such a story? Can you believe it to have happened? Can we conceive such a thing at all? It's mind-blowing. But yet, it is on record, it's on record. With humble prayers to Swami, Bhagavan, "You are mighty, you are mighty, you are great. Omniscient, omnipresent and omnipotent. We pray you to safeguard our lives and to be with us forever and evermore. Sai Ram."